Come with me if you want to live.
Hey, so 10 seconds of your time before we get started. I want you to know that I've been there. For 15 years before I got into the tech field, I was a high school English teacher, and I was also the guy who ran all the musicals and plays. All right, life changes, and I want you to know that what I'm about to tell you has worked for me, and it's also worked for many of my tech students who I've had the pleasure of working with over the last 5 years. The RHCSA exam is practical, which means that you need to practice. You need a Red Hat Enterprise Linux 9 or adjacent Linux environment to practice in. And here are some suggestions, just so you're not practicing on a potato. The Red Hat objectives do a terrible job of telling you what's actually going to be on the exam. There's no bones about it. You need training in order to get through these objectives. And Red Hat does offer training for the exam in two courses, Red Hat System Administration 1 and Red Hat System Administration 2. Thing with that is that these prices are insane. Unless your job is footing the bill for some of these, there's no way the people that are trying to break into the tech industry can afford this, even for the self-paced stuff. And there's a lot of excellent resources out there, but they can be very dense and maybe giving you more than what you need in order to just get certified. And I would humbly but genuinely suggest that you check out Alta3 Academy, the link to which is in the description, which has all of these things provided that are focused on your certification, do not waste your time, are self-paced, have a lab environment, and have videos featuring me teaching you everything you need to know. Just what you need to know for the exam. Number 3, know what your weak spots are. Mock exams can humble you and tell you exactly where it is that you need to improve. And you need to keep punching yourself in those sore spots until those are in your muscle memory, which is what you need in order to pass this exam. Number 4 is practice, practice, practice. The Red Hat exam is really high pressure, and in moments of panic, we often sink to just the level of our training. That is why if you can do these tasks in your sleep, and if it's muscle memory in your fingers, then you're gonna do great on the exam. Number 5, AI. Artificial intelligence is a game changer for exam preparation. Seriously. AI can explain concepts, re-explain concepts, dumb things down, or level things up, all depending on your skill level, in any tone. It's like having a non-judgmental Linux wizard on call 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. And here's a tip, don't cheat. If you're taking the exam in the comfort of your own home, the exam is still proctored. Somebody, a real human being, will be looking at your screen, will be watching you on a webcam, will be listening to you through a microphone. They want to make sure that you're not cheating with any cheat sheets or people underneath the table whispering the answers to you. Don't write down the questions. You have to agree when you take the exam that you won't do that, and you would never think to write that down. Because if you do wind up failing and you do wind up retaking it, there's no way that every question will be exactly the same, and you wouldn't have had all the time between the tests to, you know, figure out what you got wrong. Now, you are allowed to have bathroom breaks on the exam, 10 minutes per every hour. And don't you dare have notes hung up on the walls or have your phone, which has an AI tool that can help you figure out answers. That would just be dishonest. Besides, if you're prepared enough, you'll never need such tactics. Gang, you've got this, and we here at Alta3 have got your back. If you've got tasks on your upcoming exam that you want to learn more about, comment them down below, and I'll see you next time.